Hello friends. First, we name the interfaces to use. If you have multiple ISP connections in your network, you can send your network traffic through those ISP connections and can make a load balancing network. I will show you how to do load balancing based on client IP address. The following steps will show how to configure PPPoE client on MikroTik WAN interface. Choose your WAN interface from Interfaces drop-down menu. Configure PPPoE client on WAN 1 interface. Put your ISP given username in user input field and password in password input field. Also uncheck add default root checkbox. Configure PPPoE client on WAN 2 interface. Choose your WAN interface from Interfaces drop-down menu. Also uncheck add default root checkbox. We will now assign LAN gateway IP so that LAN user can communicate with MikroTik router. Put your LAN gateway IP in address input field. 192.168.88.0/24. Now we will create NAT rule so that our LAN user can access internet through our MikroTik router. Click on NAT tab in this window and then click on Add New button. Choose Masquerade from Action drop-down menu. Choose SRT NAT from Chain drop-down menu and put your LAN IP block address in SRT address input field. 192.168.88.0/24. Now we have to create mangle rules which will divide our LAN users into two groups and mark them for proper routing. Choose pre-routing option from chain drop-down menu and put group A IP block in address input field. 192.168.88.0/25. Choose mark routing option from action drop-down menu and put group A in new routing mark input box. Similarly, choose pre-routing option from chain drop-down menu and put group B IP block in address input field. 192.168.88.128/25. Choose mark routing option from action drop-down menu and put group B in new routing mark input box. Now you have to configure routing so that your different user group can use different WAN connection for accessing internet. Put PPPoE out 1 in gateway input field and choose group A from routing mark drop-down menu. Similarly, put PPPoE out 2 in gateway input field and choose group B from routing mark drop-down menu. After this configuration, your group A users will access internet through WAN 1 gateway and group B users will access internet through WAN 2 gateway. In the next part, I will guide you to configure redundancy in case one of the two WAN connections goes down. In the next part, I will guide you to configure redundancy in case one of the two WAN connections goes down. If this helps, don't forget to leave a like and more, subscribe to my YouTube channel for more helpful videos.